After some marginal weeks in the SEC, we finally have some games to talk about that could cause some excitement and shake things up in the conference. Most likely not, but there's that possibility. Josh Parcell joining us from College Football Country to set up the SEC, starting with Texas A&M hosting Auburn. Yes, the Tigers would need some help to win the SEC. Actually, no, they've lost the one game inside the SEC. They've got a puncher's chance. They run the table. They beat Alabama. They get to the SEC championship game. But Auburn's got to take care of business there, Josh, at Texas A&M.
So here's the interesting note in this game. The last time Texas A&M was more than a 14-point underdog in a game against anybody not named Alabama was 2014 against Auburn, where they won as outright underdogs, as 23.5-point underdogs, and they won outright. That is interesting to me. I don't know that we're going to see history repeat itself, but I think Texas A&M could be kind of a sneaky, tough team for Auburn right here. The Tigers have shown, look, when they play with a focused attitude, they come in and play their A game, they're one of the six or seven best teams in the country in my mind. But when they've shown against the likes of Mercer or LSU in the second half that they could come out and play a little bit of a flat performance, they don't have the margin for error that a team like Alabama or some of the other top teams have where they can avoid those letdown performances. I think A&M keeps this game close. I think this is a game where the Aggies could be winning late into the second half. Ultimately, I think Auburn pulls out a tight win, but do not be surprised if Texas A&M upsets Auburn.
That 2014 Auburn team coming off a appearance in the national championship game, were a top five rated team to start the season under Nick Marshall, fell to 8-5, and really the program has yet to contend for anything and has put Gus Malzahn in a position where he needs to win. He's probably done enough this year to keep his job for another campaign in 2018, but Auburn with a slim chance. So, Josh, we talked about Iowa State sneaking into the playoffs. This would be an extremely difficult path, but it's a clear path for Auburn possibly with the run of Alabama and then Georgia. They've got Georgia in the regular season. Sorry. They've got Georgia, of course, in the regular season, their annual rivalry game cross division, then Alabama, then Georgia again in the SEC championship game. You beat three of the top five teams in the country. Maybe you get in with two losses.
I don't think there's any question they'd be in if they were able to knock off Georgia twice and Alabama. I think that even with two losses, they would get into the college football playoff. Now, there's obviously the chance that, I mean, everyone else runs the table, Ohio State, Oklahoma, Notre Dame, Clemson, and you have a bunch of conference champions with one loss. I think Auburn would have enough. They would get in with two losses. They're the only team right now in the country with two losses who I think controls their own destiny to the playoff. There's some other schools like perhaps Stanford or maybe another team like a Georgia could lose two games, somebody like that. But honestly, Auburn with two losses would still make the college football playoff in my mind if they went out. Now, that's the thing is, well, your schedule is very difficult, but that gives you the opportunity if you can somehow navigate it. And we saw them a couple years ago with a couple miracles late in November against Georgia and Alabama. They got it done. Maybe they can try and catch lightning in a bottle again. I don't know if it's going to happen, but they at least have the opportunity.
Yeah, they've got a difficult opportunity, or they've got the opportunity to do what it would be expected and go 8-4. So that's the double-edged sword for the Auburn Tigers.